In this video, we're going to go over the CUDA software, infinite pre-algebra, free worksheet, graphing lines in slope-intercept form. So, our directions are to sketch the graph of each line. So let's quickly go over slope-intercept form and then apply it to each of our problems. So slope-intercept form is an equation in the form of our variable y equaling some value m times x plus a constant b. So again, y and x are our variables. M and b, well, they're just values, they're just numbers. B is a constant and m is a coefficient of x. Now m, that is the slope of the line, which tells us how steep the line is, and b is the y-intercept of the line. And what the y-intercept tells us, where slope gives us steepness, the y-intercept tells us where we're intersecting that y-axis. So I'll go over these and explain them a little bit more in depth as we work through the problems. So let's go ahead and dive into number one. Number one, we have this equation, y equals 1/4 x minus 1. So let's start by locating our slope. Our slope is the coefficient with x when we're in the form of y equals m times x plus b. So our slope m is 1/4. But the first point I want to plot on our line is going to be that y-intercept, and then I can base the slope off of that. And our y-intercept is our b value, which happens to be a negative 1. And it's a negative 1 because that 1 subtracted. And in our form, slope-intercept form, we're adding the b. So we're adding a negative 1 since that 1 subtracted. So again, our m is going to be equal to 1/4. And our y-intercept, or b, is going to be equal to negative 1. And that y-intercept is going to tell us where we intersect the y-axis, so I can start by plotting that negative 1. Right there, when x is equal to 0, y equals negative 1. And we can think about that even. If we plugged in 0 for x, 0 times 1/4 is 0, we're left with y equaling negative 1. That's why when we're in the slope-intercept form, this term, if x is 0, goes away. That's why b is our y-intercept. Now, we're going to use our slope to get our next point on our line. Slope is rise over run. So how far we change vertically over how far we change horizontally. The change in y over the change in x. So for every 1 unit we move up, we move 4 in our run. 1, 2, 3, 4. So our next point would be here at 4, 0. And we can double check this. If we were to plug in 4 for x, we'd have y equal 1/4 times 4 minus 1. 1/4 times 4 is 1. So y equals 1 minus 1. That's y equaling 0. There is our other coordinate, 4 comma 0. And that was all using that slope. Now that we have two points, that's all we need to form a line. And using a straight edge, if you have one, we're going to connect these two dots which form our line. And there we have it. And I definitely recommend when working on this to use a straight edge to draw those lines. Let's move on to number two. In number two, we have y equals negative x plus 2. We are indeed in the form of y equals mx plus b, where our y-intercept b is 2. So I'll go ahead and graph that now. When x is 0, y is positive 2. But what exactly is our slope? Well, it's the coefficient of x, whatever's multiplied to x. And we have a negative out in front, which means that negative 1 is multiplied to x. So our slope is, our m, negative 1. So that means rise over run, we go down for every 1 unit we move to the right. We go down 1 unit. So going down 1, as we go over 1, that's going to put us at this point here. And again, if you need help thinking about that rise over run, Let's write this as a fraction. Negative 1 can be written as negative 1 over 1. So I went down 1 and then 1 to the right. You could also think of it as positive 1 over a negative 1. So as I go up 1, I go 1 to the left. So there's a few different ways to think about that slope. But now that we have 2 points, we can go ahead and draw that line. And again, putting arrows on the end to signify that the line continues on in both directions. And if you remember from our slope video, we do indeed have a negative slope. And what does a negative slope mean? It means as we go to the right, we're moving down. So you can think of if you were to put a ball towards the very side, that ball is going to roll down. That is a negative slope, as opposed to a positive slope would be if we put the ball to the left-hand side, we would have to push it up the hill. That's a positive slope. So let's move on, remembering those double checks as we go on to number 3. Number 3, what's our y-intercept? Y equals mx plus b. We're adding 1. So when x is 0, y is a positive 1. And again, if you were to plug 0 in for x, 0 plus 1 does indeed equal 1. So we can get that point. What's our slope? Well, what's multiplied to x? Because it's y equals mx plus b. A positive 1 is multiplied by x because there's just 1x. So every unit we go up, we go over 1 unit as well. 1 over 1 is equal to 1. That's our slope. So for a change in y of 1 and a change in x of positive 1, that brings me to this point here. Now that I have 2 points, what can I do? I can go ahead and draw that line. And there we have it. And again, I recommend using a straight edge just to make that line a little cleaner and well-defined. And now that we have that line drawn, take a look at this. I can pick any point on this line. Let's choose this point here, and it will fit in my equation. And what I mean by fit is I mean that it's going to make my equation true. So this point I picked here is 3, 4. So that's 3 in the x and 4 in the y. So if I was to plug 3, 4 into my equation, 3 is x, I'm adding 1 to that x, does that equal y? Well, we said that y equals 4. Right here, there's my point, 3 plus 1 does indeed equal 4. So feel free to graph the line, pick any point, and try it out. That's another good double check. In number 4, we have y equals 4/3 x minus 4. What's our slope m? Our slope m is equal to 4/3, because that's what's multiplied to x, and we're in the form of y equals mx plus b. And remember, if we're supposed to be adding b, you can see here that I'm really subtracting 4, which means b is a negative 4. So let's go ahead and use those two facts and go ahead and graph the line. So if my y-intercept is negative 4, that means when I cross over this y-axis right here, that it's going to occur at negative 4. So I'll go ahead and fill that point in. Now using my rise over my run, for every 4 I go up in the positive direction, I go 3 right in the positive direction. So that's 4 up, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 3 to the right. 1, 2, 3 to this point here, which happens to be the point 3, 0. Now go ahead and connect those dots to form the line. And there we have it. And let's do a quick double check. What's the sign of our slope m? It's a positive, and you can see we do indeed have a positive slope. For number 5, y equals negative 3x minus 3. So our slope m is a negative 3 because that's what's multiplied to the x, and our y-intercept b is also a negative 3 because that 3 is subtracted. So graphing our y-intercept first, where we're crossing that y-axis, it's at negative 3, and then if our slope is negative 3, we can think of that as moving down 3 and 1 to the right, or moving up 3 and 1 to the left. Either way of thinking about it's fine. I'll just go ahead and move down 3 and then 1 to the right. So moving down 3, 1, 2, 3, and then 1 to the right, I'll be at this point here, which is 1, negative 6. Let's do a quick double check. If that's the point 1, negative 6, if I was to plug 1 in for x, you'll see I'll get negative 3 times 1 minus 3, which gives me negative 3 minus 3, which is indeed equal to a negative 6, which was the point that I plotted following along that slope. Now that we double checked, let's go ahead and connect those dots, forming our line. Let's move on to number 6. In number 6, it says that y equals 4. So let's think about this here for a second. We're looking for the form y equals mx plus b. But right now we have y equals b. That means that doesn't matter what we plug in for x, we're always going to get 4 for b. And when does that happen? That happens if m is 0. If our slope is 0, y is always equal to 4. So our y-intercept is 4, so let's go ahead and graph that. And our slope is 0, which means that it's just a horizontal line like so. Whatever we plug in for x, we're always going to get 4 for y. Let's say that x is 5, well, y is 4. Let's say that x is negative 3, y is 4. Y is always 4 when we have this kind of equation. Our slope is 0. It's a horizontal line. Moving on to the second page, we have y equals 3/5 x minus 1. So let's start with the slope. It's what's multiplied by x, which is 3/5. And our y-intercept is adding b, but you can see that we're subtracting 1, which means that b is a negative 1. Let's start by graphing that y-intercept, which occurs when x is 0, y is negative 1. Now, let's use that slope to find our next point. If we go up 3 and 5 to the right, we'll get there. So 3 in the rise, that's our change in y is a positive 3. 1, 2, 3. And our change in x is a positive 5, so we'll move to the right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. To this point here. How else could we get a positive 3/5? Well, that's if 3 was negative and 5 was negative. So we can get another point if we just use our slope in the opposite direction. So now let's go down 3 and 5 to the left. So 1, 2, 3 down and 5 to the left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's also a point that's going to fall on our line. And you can see that when we go to just connect 2 of these points, we're going to connect the third as well, because all we need is 2 points to form that line. Let's move on to number 8. Number 8, we have that x equals 5. So remember, we're looking for something in slope-intercept form, which is y equals our slope times x plus our intercept b. It doesn't matter what y is, x is always 5. So because x is always equal to 5, think about it. We can put a point here. Y could be 4, but x would still be 5. Y could be negative 3, but x is still 5, and so on. We don't even have a y-intercept. We're never crossing over this y-axis. But when we connect these points, what are we going to get? We're going to get a vertical line. And what does that vertical line mean? Our slope is undefined. As we move right or as we move left, we can't put a number to the slope. Therefore, it's undefined. An undefined slope is that vertical line. In number 9, we have y equals 3. What does that mean? Well, think about it. We're looking for the form y equals mx plus b. And if y is always 3, that means y is always b and their slope, m, equals 0. So if m equals 0, we're going to have a horizontal line. So whatever x is, y is always 3. So let's go ahead and graph that y-intercept and then draw that horizontal line. Y equals B. Y is always 3. That slope is 0. As we move to the right, we're neither moving up nor down. For number 10, our slope M is that positive 3, which I'll write as 3 over 1 when we go to graph it. And our y-intercept is B, which is that negative 2. Because it's not added, it's subtracted, so we need to account for that subtraction and make it a negative. So if B is negative 2, I'll go ahead and plot that. We cross that y-axis at negative 2, and then our slope is 3 over 1, a positive 3 over a positive 1. So moving up 3, 1, 2, 3, and over 1, we'll get to this point here. And you know what? We can apply the slope again once we get to that point. We can go up 3 and over 1 again to that point here. And same thing, we can keep applying that in either direction because it's always going to fall on that line. Once we find one point on the line, we can move according to the slope and find our next point. Let's move on to number 11. In number 11, we have y equals 4x plus 3. Our slope, m, is equal to 4, and our y-intercept, b, is equal to that positive 3. Graphing our y-intercept first, we cross the y-axis at a y-value of 3. Now, we just have to use our slope. For every 4 we go up, we go 1 to the right, because we can write this as 4 over 1. So going up 4, 1, 2, 3, up. I'm going to go off my graph if I try to go up 4. So let's apply the slope in the other direction. As opposed to positive 4 over a positive 1, let's make that slope a negative 4 over a negative 1, because a negative divided by a negative is still a positive. So now I'm going to move down 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1 to the left. That's going to give me my other point. And we can double check. Is that indeed that same slope? For every 4 we go up, we go over 1, 1, 2, 3, 4 up, and 1 to the right gets us back to that original point. So now I just gotta connect those points with a line. And there we have our line. Finally, onto the last problem on this worksheet, number 12. In number 12, our slope, m, is equal to 6 over 5, and our y-intercept, b, is equal to a positive 5. So if we were to graph that y-intercept at the start, that's right here at a positive 5. Now, if I was to try to apply this slope going up 6 into the right 5, I'm going to be well off my graph. So I'm going to change it and go down 6 and 5 to the left. A negative over a negative is still that positive. So going down 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 5 to the left, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we're going to be at our next point here. So now I'll just draw my line connecting those dots. And there we have it. That's how you graph slope-intercept form. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments below. And remember that worksheet is also linked below as well. As always, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Happy learning!